kids a jump start on their education. Local nanny and blogger Jada Pickett is here with some great activities that you can do at home. Now, these activities can help them identify numbers, shapes, letters,
yes.
Right?
Yeah, the sky is really the limit, literally. And so one tip that I love to give parents when it comes to getting the kids more involved in learning is actually paying attention to what they're gravitating to.
And what are they into?
Exactly. Like, you know, kids have little things at every stage of their life that they, you know, grab a hold in an interest to. And so for me as a nanny, the little one that I care for, he has developed a huge obsession with balloons. And so right now he's at the age where he can learn his colors, he can learn his letters, he can learn his shapes, he can learn different facial expressions. And so I wanted to incorporate that with what he loved because it would make them the experience a lot more fun and learning. So that's pretty much what we have here. So why don't you go ahead and grab a balloon, okay. And we can do an example of what we can, you know, what we do at home. A couple right now, you can write the letter, the color of the balloon, which is blue. Can't do that one.
This one's broken.
Let's try another one.
That was a good one, Jada. Yeah.
And as a safety precaution, we can keep the balloons to a minimum with the little ones. Make sure that you blow up probably at least no more than 5 and have them already tied up just so that the kids don't go and grab them on their own and put them in their mouth. That's a good size.
Is that good?
Unless you want to, you know.
I was about to pass out.
You can keep going. So, you know, like we said, we could do shapes. We can put squares, circles, triangles, numbers to teach them their numbers. You can write the color down on the actual color of the balloon to teach them exactly what color it is, such as blue. They're also learning how to read, too. And we also, you can put stickers on them, so we can do that with this one. So pick a letter.
Okay.
And you can just stick it anywhere on the balloon. It's so easy and it's so fun. That's why I love it. And there you go. You're teaching them the letter A. It's like flashcards, but it's on a balloon. And that's what I always love to tell caregivers and parents, is just to incorporate them into what they're interested in. And so that's just a fun way. And literally, you can do whatever you want. Letters, numbers, shapes.
And so much cooler than flashcards, because you can do that
boom.
Afterwards.
Yes. Exactly. Exactly. So another fun learning experience that's more engaging is scavenger hunts. I love doing scavenger hunts, especially throughout the seasons. And so what we have right here are DIY scavenger hunt bags. So instead of just doing the traditional one where you print out a sheet of paper and you just put the objects on what you want them to look for, take stickers of the actual things you want them to search for. So for fall, we want them to look for acorns and leaves.
Acorns like this.
There's different color leaves outside. So what we can do, we just pull these back and put them on the cardboard, or on the bag, the cardboard bags. And this is going to help the little guys go outside and identify and find exactly what they're looking for outside. And you guys know, with it being fall, there's tons of acorns outside falling on the ground. There are leaves. And they can go in and put them in the bag, and then they can look to show and see exactly what they learned. You guys can have fun with this, saying, go find a yellow leaf, go find a green leaf, go find a caterpillar, a butterfly, whatever. Everything that correlates to what you're wanting them to go look for.
And, of course, they can learn about the seasons and everything from that point on.
It's very, so much fun. Paying attention to what they're interested in is the key to making the experience fun, learning, and more exciting.
All right. Yeah. Great stuff from Jada Pickett, nanny and blogger. For more information on all these DIY projects, just head to our website, salive.com, and her website, of course, Stroller and Confetti,
yes.
Right? And just click on the As Seen on SA Live tab, where we've provided a link to her website. Tomorrow on SA Live,